Good afternoon, everybody. I wanted to welcome you to the first edition of Briefing 2.0. Let me first start off by thanking everybody who submitted questions to us. You placed some trust in us and the fact that we're going to try to answer your questions, so here we are. We're going to answer your questions. I want to respond to one thing up front. In some of the write-ups about this, kind of in the run-up to this briefing, a couple folks remarked on in my video, I said, yeah, well, this is going to be fun. And they said, well, you know, it's foreign policy, nothing fun about foreign policy. And I just wanted to explain what I meant. It's fun for me because this is part of something I started 3 years ago when I first came in here and have a great team that's been working with me. And it's one of the things that we want to do is use technology and its applications to try to change the way the State Department communicates, not only with the press, but also with the public. And this is an opportunity for the public to directly ask me questions and maybe somewhere on down the line, other people questions, and for you to get answers back. And I think this is part of a general trend in the way that government and its publics communicate with one another. And it's going to change over time. I think inevitably there has to be more interaction. There can't be all this change and ferment going on outside the walls of government and then government kind of continuing to operate as it has for the past 200 years. So that has to change. It'll change eventually. And hopefully this is one small part of that change. I brought in a piece of paper. I just want you to know. All it has is the names and the locations of the people asking questions. I don't know what the questions are, so I'm going to see them for the first time along with you. And then we have the final video from MMGN.
Dear Mr. McCormick, my question is regarding Israeli-Palestinian dialogue and Israeli-Syrian dialogue. Recently, we've seen Turkey more involved indirectly with Israeli-Syrian dialogue, and we've seen Saudi Arabia and Egypt involved with Israeli-Palestinian dialogue. For the most part, I haven't heard that the U.S. has been working with Saudi Arabia, nor working with Turkey, in promoting this dialogue. My question is, how can the U.S. leverage the interests of Turkey, Saudi Arabia, and Egypt in promoting final status agreement in the Israeli-Palestinian peace process and the Israeli-Syrian peace process? Thank you.
Well, he makes a good point about the involvement of regional states in the process of trying to bring peace between the Israelis and the Palestinians, and then between the Israelis and the Syrians. The Turks have lent their good offices to this effort. It's something that the Israelis and the Syrians started themselves, and basically the Israelis and Syrians haven't yet talked directly. They've used Turkey as an intermediary. We fully support that. And if at some point in the future those two parties want the U.S. to participate in that, absolutely we will. The only point we've made to the Israelis is that we don't view that as a substitute for the Israeli-Palestinian track, which in a lot of different ways is much more mature. One of the things that Secretary Rice, and I promise not to make this an advertisement for the administration, but one of the things that she has done through the so-called Annapolis process is to get Arab state buy-in, including Saudi Arabia, to the process of bringing peace between the Israelis and the Palestinians. And if we ever do get to the point of a peace treaty between the Israelis and the Palestinians, one of the big reasons will be because of Arab state buy-in. The Palestinians are not going to be able to politically agree to a deal without the support of Arab states and the buy-in to that process. And that was one of the important things that was accomplished at Annapolis. And it's important to this continuing process that's going on. He used the example, and MMGN used the example of Saudi Arabia. For the first time ever, Saudi Arabia attended a peace conference supporting the Israelis and the Palestinians under its own flag. They attended Madrid, but it was under, I think the banner of the Arab League before. So an important breakthrough, and we'll see how far we get with this process by January 20th. We'll turn it over to somebody else at that point, but however far we get, there's going to be a workable process that we turn over to the next administration, and we'll see what happens. But fundamentally, the two parties are going to need to make peace.